नमस्ते, खुश रहो बिटिया। आई जेवीएन प्रीति सिंह, फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक सिंपल एंड कंपाउंड पाउडर। सिंपल एंड कंपाउंड पाउडर टॉपिक बिलोंग्स टू द सब्जेक्ट फार्मास्यूटिक्स थ्योरी फॉर द बी फार्म फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट्स। सो नाउ वी कम टू द सिंपल एंड कंपाउंड पाउडर्स फॉर द इंटरनल यूज। In this form of powder, each individual dose is enclosed in paper. The number of ingredients is one, that is simple powder, while more than one, that is compound powder. The minimum quantity of each powder should not be less than 100 mg, for it can be handled, convinced by the patient, and can be weighed accurately. So the compound powder and simple powder for the use of internal and external use. Simple powder is contain only one ingredient, either in crystalline form or amorphous form. If powder present in crystalline form, then it is reduced to fine powder, weighed the powder and divided into number of doses and wrapped as individual dose. For example, in simple powder, dispense 6 powder of aspirin. Each powder contains 300 mg of aspirin. So the aspirin 300 mg, and the procedure of the procedure to make the simple powder: powder the aspirin and weight amount of the required quantity of the aspirin, weigh 300 mg of aspirin for each powder and wrap each powder in individual powder paper. What is the direction of this simple powder? One powder to be taken after every 8 hours. So this is the pharmacokinetic procedure of the 8 hours. First one is absorption, distribution, metabolism, and excretion. There are basic bioavailability of this simple powder is 8 hours, and half life is depend on the on this bioavailability. So now we come to the compound powders. Compound powders contain two or more than two substances which are mixed together, then divided into desired number of individual dose, then dispense into each powder paper. For example, dispense 8 powder of APC. Each powder contains 500 mg of active pharmaceutical quantity. The aspirin is 300 mg and paracetamol 150 mg and caffeine 50 mg. Weigh accurate amount of powder and mix them as per ascending order of their weight. Weigh 500 mg of the mixed powder for each powder and wrap each dose individual in powder paper. So the preparation of powder, reduction of particle size for all ingredients to the same range to prevent stratification. First one is sieving method, weighing of each ingredient and mixing packaging. So reduction of particle size, the manually operated procedure are trituration, pulverization, and levigation. Trituration is used to communicate reduce particle size and to mix powders. A porcelain preferred than glass mortar. A glass mortar is preferred for chemical that is stain a porcelain. When granules or crystalline material are to be incorporated into powder product, these materials are committed to individually and then blended together in the mortar. Now we come to the next method is pulverization. Pulverization is very important method for the fine quality of the powder. So the substance are reduced and subdivided with the additional material, that is solvent method, that can be removed easily after pulverization is completed. This technique is applied for the fine efficiency of the powder. Substance which are gummy and tend to regulate, which is resist grinding. As per camphor and volatile solvent can be reduced readily to a fine powder. Similarly, for example, we take iodine crystals may be committed with the aid of ether. In both instances, the solvent is permitted to evaporate and the powder's material is recovered. Pulverization method is based on the fine sieving method. Sieving method is very dominant as compared to the pulverization. So now we come to the next method is levigation. In this process, a paste is first formed by the addition of suitable non-solvent to the solid material. And particle size reduction then accomplished by the rubbing the paste in a mortar with a pestle or on an ointment slab using a spatula. So the next one is dusting powder. These are locally applied non-toxic preparation that are intended to have no systemic action. Requirement is homogeneous and very fine, free from irritation, flow easily, and have good covering capacity. Have good absorbing capacity, spread uniformity, and protect the skin from irritation caused by friction, moisture, and chemical irritants. So the application of dusting powder, medicated dusting powder may be applied either to intact skin or to open wound and mucous membrane. Powders applied to open wound must be sterilized and particle size should be very small. It's better to do for the micronized those pulses through 100 sieve size. What is the function of the dusting powder? Lubrication, protective and adsorbent, antiseptic, astringent and antiperspirant. So what is the packaging of the dispensed? Dispensed is zipper, top cans and pressurized pack aerosol. Aerosol protects the powder from air, moisture and contamination and more convenient for application. So this is the complete session. This session is powered by the digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. And I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it your problem by the problem resolving class. Thank you and thank you for the listening.